You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we learn about automated machine learning, how to build AI with AI, and one-click deploy to boot. Make sure you tune in. We'll see you there. Hello, and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to talk about automated machine learning with Zvi. Tell us who you are and what you do.
Hi, I'm a program manager in the Azure Machine Learning team, and we're here to talk about automated machine learning.
Fantastic. So, 30 seconds or less, what's automated machine learning and why should we care?
So automated machine learning automates part of the process of the machine learning workflow, so you don't have to worry about like all the bits, you know, the technical stuff, and it really democratizes machine learning for more than just, you know, data scientist, more for like if you're data analyst, if you're a data engineer, if you're even a business analyst, you can leverage the power of machine learning by using automated ML.
That's awesome. Well, it's a big promise. Can we dive in and take a look?
Sure.
All right, let's do it.
So you can see that here I'm in my Azure machine learning studio, and I'm in automated ML section under author, and I'm going to create a new automated ML run. So our first step is we select the data set. I already have one that I uploaded, but I can easily create a new one, either from local files or from the data store or from WAV file. So let's select the one that I've already created. And the next step would be to provide an experiment name. So I can, again, select one that I've already created, or I can create a new one. And then I need to select the target column, which is essentially what do I want to predict.
Fantastic. Right?
So in this case, it's the column name Y, which is whether the customer created a deposit to the bank or not based on the marketing that he got. And the third step would be to select the compute. The compute would be the compute power that the training job for the model will actually run on. So I already have one created, but if I don't have one, automated ML will help me create one really fast on the fly. I just need to give it a name, hit create, and that's it. Like, it takes a minute. And then the next step would be select the task type. So in this case, it's a classification because I want a yes, no on whether an effort succeeded or not. We also support regression and time series forecasting. If I'm more versed with machine learning, I can go into additional settings and set some more advanced settings. So if I want early stopping or use a different primary metric to analyze the model. And then another thing that I can do is go into the featureization settings and exclude some of the columns, right? Some of the features if I don't want them to be included, or if I want to change the feature type, right? The strategy that I want the featureizers to work on. So that's it. Basically, I'm ready. I hit create, and this will spin up the run. And that's basically all of it.
That's pretty amazing. So you basically select the data set, you configure the data, and then you configure the run, and then you're done.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And then it'll run for however long you want it to.
Yeah. So this can take a while because it will run through hundreds, probably like thousands of different combinations of models. And eventually what we'll see when the run is done is that we'll see that it's completed and there is a recommended model, right? So this is the model that automated ML said, oh, you know what, this is the best one because it reached 95.4% in the metric that we've selected. And from here, now I can also analyze all of the models that automated ML created. So you can see that there are several pages here, right, of models that were generated. And I can go deeper into any one of them and analyze the generated model.
That's cool.
So for example, I can go and see all kinds of performance charts for each of the models. So you can see here there's ROC curves and confusion metrics. And I can also see the explanations for that model, right? So I can see the global feature importance, meaning which of the features were more important to generate that model. And it's global importance, and I can also go and see a summary of all the data points that I have. Click on one of them, and I can get a local feature importance for that specific prediction, for
that
specific
cool.
row in the data.
So now that you've done that, because I mean, once the experiments are all run, you can it will give you the one that works the best, we think, but you can go and explore all the other ones. But one of the important things is once you build a model, Sometimes it's hard to put them into production. How do you do that here?
Yeah, so automated ML helps with that too. Once I'm satisfied with the model, it doesn't have to actually be like the one that was recommended. I can select any one of them. I hit the deploy button. I give the deployment a name. And that's it. Basically, all the scripts, everything will be automatically generated for me. I hit the deploy button, and that's it. Within a few minutes, I'll have a deployed model.
This is amazing because as a data scientist, it's always good to start with a baseline model that you know kind of works, and automated machine learning looks like it does that and allows you to deploy it as well.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching. We're learning all about how to use automated ML quickly and easily, as well as one-click deploy. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.